हेलो एवरीबॉडी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विश यू ए वेरी वेरी हैप्पी न्यू ईयर। लास्ट टाइम वी कुड नॉट मीट, अदर वी कुड नॉट नो एनीबॉडी, देर वॉज नो इंट्रैक्शन, द इंट्रैक्शन वॉज ओनली ऑन यूट्यूब। इन द एग्जामिनेशन हॉल आई ऑल्सो कुड नॉट रिकोगनाइज सर्टन स्टूडेंट्स। एनी वे विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट इन दिस सेमेस्टर। I will be teaching you the dynamics of machines. The dynamics of machines, I will be teaching you this subject. Dynamics of machine. Dynamics of machine is the branch of theory of machine or the branch of engineering in which we study the forces and their effects on machine elements. Dynamics of machine is the branch of engineering or is the branch of theory of machines where we discuss the forces and their effects on machine elements. When the inertia forces due to combined effects of mass and motion is considered, the study of the subject is known as kinetic, or kinetic is the branch of dynamics which deals with the inertia forces, taking into consideration the masses and the motion of the elements. Static, it is a branch which deals with the equilibrium of machines or machine elements by the application of forces where the masses of the elements are neglected. So we will be dividing the forces into two chapters, static force analysis and dynamic or inertia force analysis. There will be two separate chapters. We will discuss those chapters in detail. But today I start with a very simple and small chapter, that is flywheel. If you remember, today in the morning I sent you the video of flywheel. It was mentioning about the shape, or it was mentioning the shape of the flywheel, how it rotates. Actually, the flywheel is a rotating machine element which is connected to the engine crankshaft. Flywheel is a rotating machine element which is connected to the engine crankshaft. It is very important in certain applications where the turning moment of the engine is varying. Sugarcane mills, riveting operations, fabrications, welding operations, punching operations, in all these operations, the flywheel or the application of flywheel plays very important role. How it plays important role? We will be discussing today in this beginning of this chapter. So, first of all, I want to advise you that everybody should go through the books. You should develop a habit of study at your homes. We just can give you the idea about the subject, but you will have to study it in detail at your own hostels or at your own rooms. So for that, you must have books with you. Once you have books with you, whatever I teach in the class, then you study yourself at your homes, and the matter will be clear. totally dependence on teacher is not sufficient. It is also very important to carry out any competition nowadays, because there is scarcity of jobs. For that you must have the vast knowledge of the subjects. So the class teaching as well as the reading or the studying of the books is very important. I think you must be knowing me. I am Dr. B.P. Singh, Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, PEC, Dame University. Though there was no face-to-face interaction, but still, I remember few of you. And if at all in the subject you have any type of problem, you can get the clarification even by mails or in the group. Put your problems, drop your problem in the group, class group, and I will clarify it as I was doing last time also. So what is a flywheel? A flywheel acts as energy reservoir for storing and releasing mechanical energy of the engine. A flywheel acts as a energy reservoir for storing and releasing mechanical energy of the engine. During the working stroke in the engine, when energy is produced and it is more than the requirement, the speed of the engine increases. This energy produced during the working stroke is not distributed among the idle strokes if there is no flywheel, and it results into the decrease of the engine. It is not desirable that the engine speeds varies. We want that the speed of the engine should be uniform throughout the operation. It should not vary. And the variations in the speed of the engine because of variation in the turning moment are overcome by the application of flywheel. During the working stroke, as I told you, the flywheel absorbs the excess energy. During the working stroke, the flywheel absorbs the excess energy, and during idle stroke, it gives to the engine because it is connected to the engine crankshaft. Thus, the flywheel makes it possible to get uniform distribution of available energy throughout the cycle and reduces the variation in the speed of the engine. The function of the flywheel is continuous from cycle to cycle. The function of the flywheel is continuous from cycle to cycle. The flywheel stores energy. The flywheel stores energy by virtue of its mass and energy. The flywheel stores energy by means of its mass and speed. As you know, the flywheel is a rotating machine element connected to the engine shaft, engine crankshaft. So, by virtue of this formula, the flywheel stores the energy. It means 1 by 2, I is equal to mk square, mass moment of inertia of the flywheel into mega square. So, it is the mass, radius of gyration, and the angular speed of the flywheel which makes it capable to store some energy in it. So by virtue of its mass and the speed, the flywheel stores this much amount of energy, that is E, capital E. So capital E is the mean speed stored by the flywheel. In machines where the operation is intermittent, such as punching, riveting, fabricating, etc., flywheel is used. Thus, a flywheel controls the variation. Thus, the flywheel controls the speed variations caused by the fluctuation of engine turning moment. During each cycle, I again repeat, a flywheel controls the speed variations caused by the fluctuation of engine turning moment during each cycle of operation. You know that turning moment, what is turning moment? Turning moment of the flywheel, turning moment of the engine is given by this formula. Sin theta plus sin 2 theta by 2n. The turning moment, T is the turning moment of the engine is given by this formula, where T is the turning moment, FP is the piston effort, FP is the piston effort, R is the crank radius, theta, angle made by the crank, with inner dead center. Theta is the angle made by the crank with the inner dead center. L, what is L? L is the length of the connecting rod. L, length of connecting rod. Length of connecting rod. N is equal to L by R. And the working of the engine is like this. There is a piston. This is the piston effort, FP. This is the length of the connecting rod. And this is theta. This is omega. A it is like this. FP is the piston effort. AB is the crank. AB is equal to R. AB is the crank. Rotating in clockwise sense with angular velocity omega. CB is the length of the connecting rod. And theta is the angle made by the crank with the inner dead center. Suppose this angle is phi. I will discuss this formula in detail in the next chapter. But I thought it proper to take the simplest and easiest chapter first. We will derive this formula in the next chapter. T is equal to FP, piston effort is the force acting on the piston. R is the crank radius, sin theta plus sin 2 theta by 2n. I think you must be remembering this formula. The velocity of the piston is given by this. The velocity of the piston, VP, was given by omega into r sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n. I did it last time in kinematics of machines. Anyway, the T is the turning moment. T turning moment, it will be established in detail in the next chapter. T is the turning moment. Turning moment. Turning moment. So the turning moment is given by this formula. Fp is the piston effort, a force acting along the line of stroke from this side. Of course, the mass and the weight of the piston must be acting downwards. We will discuss all these things in the next chapter. Fp r sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n. Fp piston effort acting along the line of stroke. R crank radius. L length of the connecting rod CB. AB is the crank radius, that is R. And theta angle made by the crank with the line of stroke. So this formula is there. That is T is the turning moment. T is the turning moment. You see, there are two variables, T and theta. If you draw a curve between T and theta, that curve or diagram is known as turning moment diagram. The next thing is T theta diagram or turning moment diagram. If a curve is drawn between T and theta, it is known as turning moment diagram. If a curve is drawn between T and theta, it is known as turning moment diagram. The value of T will be varying continuously. The value of T will be varying continuously with the variation of theta. The value of T will be varying continuously with the variation of theta. If a curve is drawn between T and theta, it is known as turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram. It is a curve between T and theta. T, I again rewrite it. T is equal to Fp into R sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n. It is the turning moment. It is varying with the variation of crank rotation theta. T is varying with the variation of theta. Theta is the angle of rotation of the crank with inner dead center. So if a curve is drawn between T and theta, so that curve is known, or that figure is known as turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram of the engine. If suppose it is like this, suppose the turning moment diagram is like this. So the area between T and theta, the area between T and theta will be known as the work done by the engine. The work done by the engine is given by this, the area of this curve. The area, the covered area or enclosed area between T and theta will be known as work done by the engine. If we want to find the work done by the engine from stage 1 to stage 2, so that will be this area. If we want to find the work done by the engine from stage 1 to 2, so that will be this area. So I want to tell you through this presentation that turning moment diagram is the graphical representation. Turning moment diagram is the graphic representation between T and theta. Turning moment diagram is the graphical representation between T and theta. When theta is 0, there will be no turning moment. When theta is 90 degree, then it will be maximum and it will be Fp into r. This term will be 0, this will be 1. Then turning moment will be the piston effort into crank radius. So depending upon the value of theta, the value of T will be varying, and if you draw a curve between T and theta, it will be known as turning moment diagram. Turning moment diagram is sometimes known as crank effort diagram. Turning moment diagram is also known as crank effort diagram, and it is a graphical representation between T and theta. Now, the value of T will be varying continuously with the crank rotation theta. Or if a graph is drawn between T and theta, the diagram so obtained will be known as turning moment diagram. And the area of the turning moment diagram for a particular cycle, the area of turning moment diagram for a particular cycle represents the work done during that cycle. There are different diagrams for different cycles. Different turning moment diagrams for different cycles. To example a few, I present it for you. The turning moment diagram for different cycles will be different. I draw the turning moment diagram for this is T theta diagram for steam engine. T and this is theta. Here the T is maximum. T maximum. Here, suppose it is pi by 2. It is 3 pi by 2. It is T mean. Maximum value. What is T mean? It is the minimum work done by the engine. T mean means mean resisting torque. And this is the maximum torque. Mean resisting torque line. And this is the maximum value of T. This is the minimum value of T. Minimum value of T is known as T mean. It means engine should do at least this much work. This much work. Engine should do at least this much work to move it start. If you see from situation 1 to 2 for this much rotation, the work done by the engine is less than the mean resisting torque line. So engine will not start. Engine will start only when the work done by the engine is more than the requirement. And the minimum requirement for the engine to run is at least this much work. Engine will start only when the work done by it is at least equal to the mean resisting torque line or even more than that. Otherwise, engine will not start functioning. So this is known as mean resisting torque line, and this is the maximum torque line. So to move the engine run, at least this much work should be done by the engine. So here you see the work is done more than the requirement. So this much is the requirement, and this much amount of energy is reserved or is conserved in the flywheel itself. So the requirement is this much, and this much excess amount of energy from here to here will be absorbed by the flywheel. Then again the turning moment is going down like this, from this position to this position, from 1 to 2, from 2 to 3. From 2 to 3 position, the energy produced by the engine is less than the requirement here. The requirement is at least up to this line, but the energy produced is going down. So this is positive energy, positive loop, this is negative loop. The positive amount of, or the plus amount of energy is reserved or is absorbed by the flywheel, and that amount of energy is distributed by the flywheel for rest of the strokes. Now from situation 2 to 2, or from rotation point 2 to 3, there is a loss of energy, and loss of energy is, the loss of energy is shown by, the loss of energy is shown by red area. This is the loss of energy. Theoretically, the engine should not start. It should not run. But this much amount of excess energy, which is absorbed by the flywheel, is distributed to rest of the stroke.